Dan Walkcaster.
Hello. Thank you for choosing Japan Walkcaster's Little Kyoto in Tokyo Yanaka Tour. Japan Walkcaster will show you the sights of this unique area at your own pace. Each audio point marked on the accompanying course map corresponds to the track number, so you should start track 2 when you reach audio point 2. We would first like to explain how to use this guided audio tour. Each track gives instructions as to when and where to walk to next. The time to complete this tour from start to finish is listed on the tour map, but actual time will depend on how much time you spend at each location and on how fast you walk. You can, if you wish, take this tour in any order. Just play the audio that corresponds to the number you wish to hear. At the end of each track, you will hear the following sound. To ensure your safety while taking this tour, please be aware of your surroundings, including fellow pedestrians, vehicles, and bicycles. In general, Japanese traffic stays left. Always use designated pedestrian crossings and resist walking against the light. It is not only dangerous, but laws against jaywalking are enforced. We also recommend that you do not take this tour after dark for your own safety. The start of this tour is exit 1 of Sendagi Station, station number 15 on the Chiyoda Line. You should now be at point 1. You are standing at Sendagi Station on street level after going out exit 1. With the station entrance to your back and the intersection to your immediate left, let's begin. The intersection on your left is Dangozaka Shita, or lower dumpling slope. Dango is a small dumpling made from pounded rice and flavored with a variety of coverings. Dangozaka is named for dango because some say it resembles dango on a skewer. Yanaka is famous for many things other than dango, but before you finish your tour, be sure to try some for yourself. Let's now cross the intersection kitty corner where you will find more room to stop and listen to the rest of the Little Kyoto in Tokyo Yanaka Tour introduction. The area that you will be walking through today is an ancient one. From at least 10,000 years ago, when the valley you are standing in was an extended inlet of Tokyo Bay, people known as the Jomon, followed by the Yayoi, lived in the hills that make up modern Sendagi, Yanaka, and Nezu. Many changes, both geographical and historical, have occurred since those distant days. But compared to other areas in Tokyo, this area escaped the wrath of the Kanto earthquake in 1923 and the ravages of World War II, as well as the bulldozers of the voracious land developers in the 80s and 90s. Even as late as the early Meiji period, which began with the fall of the Tokugawa shogunate in 1868, this area marked the edge of Edo, present-day Tokyo. The lands beyond Yanaka, Shitaya, today's Iria, Negishi, and Asakusa, up to the Sumida River, were primarily woods and rice paddies. Edo is not an old city, certainly by comparison with Kyoto, but its name is. The name itself derives from a junior member of the Taira clan who settled in the Chichibu area and built a fortified compound in the late 1100s. The Taira clan at this time was fighting for supremacy with the Minamoto clan. Their conflicts would usher in the age of the warrior in Japan. This minor Taira clan member took the name Edo Shigenaga, And he was, in fact, a supporter of the Minamoto clan that would eventually destroy the Taira. His family name, Edo, means mouth of the river, a reference to the location of his compound. After Shigenaga's death, his descendants split up and were little heard of. Today, we owe his descendants for the names of areas in modern-day Tokyo, names like Shibuya, Maruko, and Iikura, for example. After this, not a lot is heard from the Kanto until 1457, when Ota Dokan built his castle on the same site as that of the Edo compound, the same location that would one day become the center of the Tokugawa shogunate and later become home to the Emperor of Japan. Tokugawa Ieyasu supported both Oda Nobunaga and his successor, Toyotomi Hideyoshi, the two 16th century warlords credited with the unification process of Japan that Ieyasu would finish. However, he never failed to keep his own interest at heart. His family domain at this time was located in the strategic provinces that lay astride the East Sea Road from Kyoto to the east. Their strategic value led Toyotomi Hideyoshi to offer Ieyasu the 8 eastern provinces in exchange, and he readily agreed, despite opposition by his senior retainers. It was not until Hideyoshi himself was dead that Ieyasu made his move to unify and control all of Japan, culminating in his decisive victory at the Battle of Sekigahara in 1600. Ieyasu solidified his control over the whole of Japan and became shogun in 1603. He then turned his attention to his capital with a vigorous building program. And to this day, construction in Tokyo has seldom, if ever, ceased. In the beginning of the 17th century, as Ieyasu and his retainers began to lay the foundations for his city and dynasty, great foresight was shown in the layout of Edo. That insight had ramifications for the area you are about to see today. Following the requirements of Chinese geomancy, the art of arranging cities and buildings auspiciously, there should be a mountain in the north, which was the Black Warrior's domain. Mount Fuji sort of fit this requirement. In the direction of the Green Dragon, the east, there must be a river, and the Sumida River fit this requirement well. To the west, the domain of the White Tiger, there should be a road. The Tokaido Road running along the coast was a perfect fit. In the direction of the Red Bird in the south, there should be a pond. Edo Bay was an acceptable substitute. Since Mount Fuji was actually southwest from where the castle's main entrance gate should be positioned, Ieyasu and his retainers simply relocated the entrance gate, Otemon, to the east, allowing Mount Fuji to take up its proper position in the north. Next, Ieyasu focused on plans to make his castle unassailable. His retainers and advisors devised a plan that even today is evident in modern Tokyo. With his castle at the center, Ieyasu had a series of canals in concentric circles constructed to ring the castle, making use of the abundant water sources from the many rivers and ponds in the area. Today, the major roads and expressways follow these waterways and form circles around Tokyo. Commuter lines like the JR Yamanote line also run in large circles around Ieyasu's castle, what is today the Imperial Palace. We will be walking through what in the early Edo period formed the outer edge of the castle's defense system. Indeed, the area was to provide a valuable service to the Tokugawa and was instrumental in why the area has survived the fate of most other areas of post-Edo Tokyo. Because this area is to the northeast of the castle, called Kimon, the direction from which evil demons come from and bring misery and suffering to the people, the second Tokugawa shogun, Hidetada, ordered Kaneiji to be built as the guardian temple of the shogunate at the demon's gate. The temple also became a mortuary temple for Tokugawa shoguns, six of whom were buried there. From the early 1600s, other temples were encouraged to relocate here, not only to form a buffer to protect against invasion, but to cane the fire danger, since temples were a constant source of the flowers of Edo, the devastating fires that ravaged the city. Today, the majority of these temples are of the Nichiren sect, although Zen, Tendai, and temples from other sects can be found here. The main road to the southwest went through this area of Edo, and is said that Nichiren, founder of the sect, traveled through Yanaka in the 13th century, preaching on his way to and from Kamakura. Sendagi, where we currently are at, was home to the shogun's falconers, and the whole Sendagi, Yanaka, and Nezu area was known in the Edo period for its scenic woodlands and clear streams. In the Meiji period, 1868 to 1912, the area became a favorite area for artists and the literati. Today, there are over 70 temples in the area, largely escaping the devastation from the 1923 Kanto earthquake, and for the most part, ignored by United States Air Force bombing raids during World War II. The area was protected from land developers by the collapse of the economy in the late 1980s. As a result, this area maintains a charm not easily found in modern Tokyo.